Hello MBA aspirants. Welcome to MBA Dr. CTC, that is Concept to Completion. I'm Dr. Vinita Singh, and in my previous podcast titled Interview Preparation for Top Business Schools Part 2, I spoke about different types of interview questions. While I continue to help students with essays, recommendations and interviews with almost 100% success rate, today through this podcast titled Meditation for MBA Interview Preparation, Best Tips and Strategies for Top Business Schools, I'm going to share some very important and noteworthy tips and strategies that will come handy and will help you loads when appearing for an MBA interview for top business schools. With my experience of being a Reiki master for more than 20 years and my consistent effort towards meditation combined with knowledge and wisdom of Sadhguru's Inner Engineering and Bhavaspandana course, I'm extremely happy and eager to help MBA aspirants understand the tips and strategies for the complete interview process for the top business schools through this meditation. Let me begin with a beautiful quote conveying the essence of success. The more you sweat in peace, the less you bleed in war. There is no shortcut to hard work. Let us begin. For the next few minutes, let your creative mind lead you. I suggest use your headphones and go through the complete meditation once. Look through the meditation again and take pauses where and when necessary to understand where all you could improve in your approach, preparation, and content of your stories. As we commence, please find a comfortable position and place your hands with palms facing upwards in your lap. Close your eyes to see more and co-create your success for getting an admit from your dream business school. Observe the inflow and outflow of your breath. With each breath, relax and make yourself ready to face the interview. Imagine yourself getting ready for the interview. You have reached on time and have carried out all the essential steps carefully. You're carrying the necessary documents and you are calm. You're looking your best with rightly combed hair, business formal clothes, and you are enthusiastically alert and vigilant to appear for the interview. See yourself greeting the interviewer with a firm handshake and a smile. You're sitting down as you have been invited to do so. You are careful about your posture, your body language, and eye contact. Are you wearing glasses? And have you made sure your glasses are clean? You have given due attention to appearance, physical energy, and have appropriately taken care of the hygienic necessities. You have prepared very well for the interview. The interview has begun. Observe your gestures. They are moderate while making any point. You are extremely careful in understanding the question, and you are handling tough questions in a very matured manner without showing your nervousness. You are being professional without being stiff and rigid. You know you need to be yourself. Take a deep breath. Observe yourself. You are listening carefully and speaking in an energetic way with well-modulated tone. You're not trying to impress. You're not wasting your time and the admissions officer's time by just praising the school and not trying to convey the real content. This is a strange situation. The question is not related to your career goals and the fit part to the school. You are glad that you have understood it. It is about your accomplishment, and you know you have to talk about your achievements, leadership examples of your work experience or academic background, conveying your greatest strengths and weakness if the question demands so. You are well aware that even if there is no direct question, you need to talk about your work experience, your future vision, the nature of job after you complete your MBA, and why have you chosen that school and how do you fit into that school. You had gone an extra mile and researched about the verbal mannerism of the place where your school is located. You had also prepared for a cross-cultural interview by being more aware and by spending more time on simulated mock interviews with friends and other well-informed people. So, you are answering the questions well. Oh, you had not expected this. Your interviewer is talking a lot and is not paying much attention to you and is rude and is interrupting you repetitively. You are calm, as you know that your purpose is to project your abilities and show that you are the right fit for the school. You know you need to be very balanced, peaceful, and professional to present yourself in a flawless manner. Your practice through mock interviews is giving you a realistic view of the situation. You had video recorded your mock interviews so that you could see yourself in action in terms of your content, speech, style, and also your outfit, keeping a perfect track of the time. What is this? An unusual interview format. You have been asked to give a presentation and there is going to be a group discussion of a case. You are thinking of your strategy. You are confident as you know that the idea is the same, to check your interpersonal, team, communication, and maybe analytical skills. You have handled it very well. You know you do not have to get too influenced by the tone and gestures of the interviewers. So, you are being your best. You are paying utmost attention, and here the interviewer is asking you to ask a question to the admissions committee. You had prepared and you have asked the question. Your interviewer is replying and you are listening to the answer. Interview is about to finish. You know you cannot ask the interviewer about your performance after the interview is over. Your first interview is almost ending and you have performed well. You are thanking all the interviewers in the panel and moving out. It is your time to feel relaxed. Breathe in and breathe out. Bring your awareness back. Inhale and exhale slowly and gradually. Open your eyes. Assess yourself and analyze where you went right and where you could have been better. Do not forget to send a brief thank you note to the interviewer. You want to be better prepared with some questions that could be asked as per the mentioned strengths and weaknesses in your profile in the next interview. Friends, let me close with three important tips. For a telephonic or Skype interview, do not read out the answers. Check the connection, lighting, sound, and make sure that you dress as if you are appearing for an in-person formal interview. Second tip is, work towards communication skills so that your English is correct and convey. Answers are not too scripted. Goals are clear. Social media profiles on LinkedIn, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter convey a matching story. Third tip is to keep the admissions committee informed of any untoward incident. It is vital. Friends, in this video podcast, I spoke about some extremely important tips and strategies for the interview process through meditation. You can check the links of all my videos in the description box. Do not forget to subscribe and like, and leave a comment if you think I missed out any important tip. May all your aspirations come true and you get an admit from your dream business school. Take care, stay safe, and watch out for my next video podcast.